Are you a fan of poetry? Does different types of poetry and style of writing excite you? Have you heard of what assonance in poetry is? If you're looking for some examples of assonance in poetry, you've come to the right place. Read the following article to find more information. Have you ever picked up a poetry book and read the poems not knowing what they mean or what style of poetry they are? When we are kids, learning about different types of poetry, figures of speech, and various styles of writing can be quite confusing. Although, when it comes to understanding the meaning behind what assonance is, there are times even adults can be baffled by it. It's natural. People who like to do casual reading end up stumbling upon great poems, but without the knowledge of what or how it was constructed. So is the use of assonance in poetry as well. The lines or phrases that make up the entire poem can use various types of poetry, and assonance is one of them. And in the following article, we are going to see some examples. But before we take a look at the various examples of assonance in poems by famous poets, why not understand the meaning of assonance first? What is assonance? In a poem, when a particular line or phrase has similar vowel sounds, it's called assonance. In English language poetry, assonance is used to create rhymes even within the lines or phrases. With assonance, the sound of the vowel matches with another word in the same line. Although while rhyming, the words don't necessarily have to be accurate, as in cat and rat or lime and time. The stress is basically on using similar vowels such as ban and cat. The assonance here is the same, but the consonant is different, no T in the end. So, in short, use of vowels A, E, I, O, U and periodic use of repetition of similar sounding words makes up for assonance. Now that we have understood the meaning of assonance, let's take a closer look at the examples not just in poems, but in literature as well. Examples in assonance. While you're reading the poems below, try to search for the use of assonance in the lines. Although the poems have been underlined, you can still try to understand the use on your own. The Bells. By Edgar Allan Poe. Hear the mellow wedding bells, golden bells. What a world of happiness their harmony foretells. Through the balmy air of night how they ring out their delight. From the molten golden notes, and all in tune, what a liquid ditty floats to the turtle dove that listens, while she gloats on the moon. The world is too much with us. By William Wordsworth. The world is too much with us. Late and soon, getting and spending, we lay waste our powers. Little we see in nature that is ours. We have given our hearts away, a sordid boon. This sea that bears her bosom to the moon, the winds that will be howling at all hours, and are upgathered now like sleeping flowers, for this, for everything, we are out of tune. It moves us not. - Great God. I'd rather be a pagan suckled in a creed outworn. So might I, standing on this pleasant lea, have glimpses that would make me less forlorn. Have sight of Pertus rising from the sea. Or hear old Triton blow his wreathed horn. El Dorado. By Edgar Allan Poe. Galeb died, a gallant knight in sunshine and in shadow, had journeyed long, singing a song, in search of El Dorado. But he grew old, this knight so bold, and, o'er his heart a shadow fell as he found no spot of ground that looked like El Dorado. And, as his strength failed him at length, he met a pilgrim shadow. Shadow, said he, where can it be, this land of El Dorado? Over the mountains of the moon, down the valley of the shadow, ride, boldly ride, the shade replied, if you seek for El Dorado. The Feast of Famine. By Robert Louis Stevenson. From folk that sat on the terrace and drew out the even long sudden crowings of laughter, monotonous drone of song. The quiet passage of souls over his head in the trees. And from all around the haven the crumbling thunder of seas. Farewell, my home, said Rua. Farewell, O quiet seat. Tomorrow in all your valleys the drum of death shall beat. Other examples in poems. Besides the illustrations we discussed in the article, there are other famous poets who have incorporated the style in their own work. Here's a small list of their great literary works. Daffodils by William Wordsworth, How Happy is the Little Stone by Emily Dickinson, The Lotus Eaters by Alfred Lord Tennyson, Fire and Ice by Robert Frost, Frost at Midnight by Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Travel by Edna St. Vincent, Millay Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. These were some examples of assonance in poetry. Besides these, there are other examples in literature such as Julius Caesar and Romeo and Juliet. And as for songs, perhaps you've heard the songs If Everyone Cared by Nickelback, According to You by Orianthe, and Baby by Justin Bieber. Now if we have left out any other examples that you may be aware of, please leave us a comment below. We'd love to hear from you.